At the time, an all-white school board that ousted the state's youngest, most popular superintendent that we've ever had, who just happened to be a very woke black man. And folks came in droves to protest the ousting of this superintendent, which was important. And we can't dismiss people's emotions, because when it comes to people's lives and their children, we're allowed to be on the show. Yeah. The NRA is emotional every day, and I don't see people talk to them, and they prey on people's emotions. So we can walk and chew gum at the same time. I can be emotional and logical at the same time. I can stand up for my children with passion and make sure that I'm using every tool that I have at my disposal. So people showed up at that school board, and everybody was very clear. We're here to get you out. So they passed around a clipboard, got everybody's information in the room, and yes, people showed up to let off their anger and to make sure that people were paying attention. Then those same folks signed a petition to support the lawsuit, because essentially the districts were so gerrymandered that a majority black school district had an all-white school board. And the judge eventually ruled that unconstitutional, right? So we used our legal tools, we used our tools of protest, and we used our tools of the voter box, right? This is what I'm talking about not getting caught up in two sides or both sides of anything. I'm talking about staying caught up in black people and black agendas and the future.